In this video, I'm going to break down three ways to make an isometric game. Also, I will help you decide which one is the best for you. As an example, I will show you how to set up basic projects in Unity, for all cases, but this concept can be used in any engine. Some of the stuff we're going to talk about is building placement, character movement, isometric art, and more. My name is Tamara and welcome to my channel. To begin with, let's look at isometric view in general and why we developers choose it for our games. As the definition says, isometric projection is a method for visually representing three-dimensional objects in two dimensions. In video games, it helps the player get more details about the world. Isometric games have begun their story when 3D wasn't possible yet. Isometric view has allowed games to look 3D, but still have the detailed look. Nowadays, isometric is more like an aesthetics choice, but in fact, this is just the best option to represent all three dimensions of an object. Take a cube in an isometric view. We can see three sides of it, whereas in other 2D views like top-down or side view, we can only see one side or two sides max. Another example is the shape of a person. From a three-quarters view, it looks great, but from above, it's just a head with no visible body. But then there is a trade-off of being more complicated to work with in general. Programming, drawing, and game design is going to be a little bit different, and maybe not as straightforward as developing the game in another perspective. In engineering drawings, isometric view is when the three coordinates axes appear equally foreshortened and the angle between any two of them is 120 degrees. But in games, we use a different principle with ratios. Despite the name, isometric computer graphics are not necessarily truly isometric. The X, Y, and Z axes are not necessarily oriented 120 degrees to each other. Instead, a variety of angles are used, with diametric projections and a 2 to 1 pixel ratio being the most common. The terms 3/4 perspective, 3/4 view, 2.5D, and pseudo-3D are also sometimes used, although these terms can bear slightly different meanings in other contexts. And now, we will look at three ways to achieve an isometric view in a game. But before we get to that, be sure to subscribe to this channel to see more game dev content like tips, tutorials, and devlogs. Hit that like button to help more people see this video. Also, I have a Patreon page where you can get the materials from this video. Support me now and get some extra content from me. Link is in the description. Isometric 2D. This view is achieved using sprites drawn in isometric projection. It was used in the first isometric games. It is like the classic isometric view. I'm currently developing a town simulation with this type of view, so I can tell you what the advantages and disadvantages of it are, from a first-hand experience. By the way, I have a devlog series about this game where I show a lot of useful stuff about developing an isometric city builder in Unity. You can watch it here. First, a brief instruction on how to set up this in Unity. To visualize things, let's create an isometric grid. Unity offers two options for this, a regular isometric grid and Z as Y isometric grid. The difference between them is just the rotation of the axes and how you use the coordinates. Let's choose a regular one. Another way around this is to create a custom grid script. Either way, you have to specify the ratio of your cells. As I've already mentioned, it is 2 to 1 ratio. And here you have it, an isometric grid. But how do we use it? Well, you can draw some isometric tiles and use them to create a map, or as I did in my game, use regular objects and snap them to grid. For these objects, you would need to draw isometric art. There are some tutorials on this topic on YouTube, so you can watch and practice. I want to mention that with isometric perspective, it's tricky to sort sprites. In Unity, there is a simple solution for this. Set the pivot point to the bottom of the sprite. This should do the work for the objects that are not too wide. Also, I want to mention that a grid gives you an advantage to make a building system on it. I even made a tutorial on how to make a grid building system in Unity, so if you're interested in making one and your game is 2D, you can watch it here. As for the movement, you would have to move an object on both X and Y axes. This is because we are faking the 3D look with isometric sprites, but the coordinates stay in the Cartesian system. Advantages and disadvantages. Now, let's look at the advantages of a 2D isometric view. I will be mostly comparing it to a 3D approach, because if you clicked on this video, you probably want to make an isometric game, so there is no point to compare it to any other perspective. Let's just say that it can be really hard sometimes to fix the problems with this type of view. but for the sake of aesthetics, we can deal with those. Since this U is achieved by making the graphics look isometric, we're going to compare it. Making isometric sprites is much easier and faster compared to making a full 3D model. This is especially important if you're making a complex game with lots of graphics. Isometric pixel art can be learned quickly, even if you're not an artist. 3D art can be learned too, but the amount of detail you can get on these models as a beginner is not satisfying. And if you try, you would probably spend too much time on it, and you won't even get to the programming part. Also, I'd like to mention that user input is easier than it is in 3D. Since we're working with a 2D space, we can just use the standard methods to convert from screen space to world space. Disadvantages. With a 2D approach, it is harder to fake the environment completely. Sprite sorting is one of the issues you have to deal with, but there is more. In this view, you can't really have lights and shadows set up properly. The environment has to be faked entirely on the art side of the project. You would have to add shadows to your buildings and characters right after you draw them and not in the game engine. Actually, as I was making this video, I came across a tutorial on how to make a fully lit isometric tiles in Unity. This means that you can add shadows to your 2D sprites. I left a link to that video in the description. Another issue that I think is worth mentioning is rotations. If you're making a city builder, you'd probably want to make it possible to rotate things. Or even a better example, character movement animations. In 2D, animations can be achieved in two ways: by quickly going through a set of slightly different images and by animating separate components of a character. Both these things are not intuitive to make in isometric, so there is a high chance you will mess things up. Isometric 3D. Another way to achieve the isometric effect is to make a 3D world and rotate the camera to specific degrees. This view can look a little bit less aesthetic, but it is still considered isometric. It gives you various advantages over the 2D approach, however, you would need to sacrifice some of the things too. I will talk about the pros and cons of it a little bit later. For now, let's just look at how to make it. To set it up in Unity, you need to create a 3D project and rotate the camera to 30 degrees on the x-axis and to 45 degrees on the y-axis. Also, make the camera perspective orthographic. This will ensure that the objects that are farther from the viewpoint are not getting smaller. The thing is, with this approach, is that you're faking the isometric perspective by making the camera view look isometric. If you want to implement a grid snapping, you can no longer use the standard 2D grid. It means that you have to write a custom grid script for this. As for the player movement, you can easily treat it like it's just a 3D game. Import a 3D model of a character into the game and make it move. You could probably use Unity's NavMesh for pathfinding in this approach, since you can turn the character model in any direction. Advantages and disadvantages. When I was making my 2D isometric game, I ran into a problem with animating a character. I used captured animations made from a 3D model. I had to make a lot of sprite sheets to achieve a variety of animations for one character. With the 3D approach, it would have been easier to put an animated character into the game. Moreover, it would be easier to make many characters. You can just reuse the animations for different models. In 2D, you have to do a lot more work for each character. With this approach, it is easier to create the overall environment. First of all, shadows and lights are possible to use now, and with these elements you can create a really beautiful scene. Second, now you don't have to worry about sprite sorting issues, because everything is in order. Also, rotations are now easy and possible. As you can see, a lot of things that are hard to do with the 2D approach are now easier, but let's look at what we'd be giving up if we were to choose this approach. Disadvantages. The main problem with this approach is that you don't have the same aesthetics in the scene. It can still look good, but it just won't be the same. This is due to the fact that with 3D models, there won't be much detail on the objects. Don't get me wrong, you can of course make amazing things in 3D modeling software, but the truth is, it will take up so much more time to achieve the same amount of detail that you could get from a 2D sprite. In addition, 3D modeling takes time to learn, and you might not afford to spend a few months learning it. This leads us to the next drawback of the 3D approach: time consumption. If you're making a game which has a lot of buildings, which is probably the case because an isometric view is suitable for this type of games, you would need to make or find a lot of 3D models. Even if you have some models at hand, modifying them will take time too. For example, with my 2D isometric art, I was able to make some changes easily using Photoshop. This really helped me make my game look the way I imagined it to be. Now, let's look at something that is a combination of the previous approaches, isometric 3D with a 2D environment. In my opinion, this is the best approach for an isometric view. Well, maybe not in all cases, but we will talk about this more later. Stay tuned to hear about what method is the best for your game. The principle for this is simple. You create a 3D project where you can operate with 3D models, but when you get to the point where you have to construct the environment, you use 2D sprites. I first saw this approach in a game that I used to play when I was a kid. Even then, I noticed that the graphics used for making up the environment were flat, whereas the characters, little ponies, were really smoothly animated and moved into various directions. When I started making my dream game Leah and learning about isometric view more, I finally realized what it was in that game and why the developers went with that approach. Unfortunately, it was too late for me to switch to a 3D project at the time, so now I'm continuing to use the standard 2D approach. Let me show you this in Unity. I created a 3D project and rotated the camera just like I did with the 3D approach. Then I created a sprite and assigned an image of an isometrically drawn house. I rotated the sprite to the same angles as I did the camera. And if we look at the camera view, we can see that we have the illusion of a house standing on the ground. Now, let's add a collider to this house, so that the characters don't pass through it. This part is a little bit tricky. Create a cube and modify it so the size approximately fits the house. And then, just disable its mesh renderer, so all we can see is the collider. You can copy and paste this component on the sprite object directly, or just set this invisible cube as a child of the sprite. With this type of approach, you will be able to get the same detailed look of the game, and you will also get the pros of using a 3D project. You can animate the character with different movements and make your game world alive. Advantages and disadvantages. Advantages. As I've already told you, you can get the same amount of detail with this view as you can with a 2D approach. This will bring back the significant atmosphere that can be found in isometric games. You can add the elements that you want to the buildings, learn some pixel art and make your game world beautiful. This approach has the same pro that I talked about when I was describing a 3D approach. Animating the character is easier and more scalable. As for the disadvantages, the graphics might look a little bit strange together. It's not like it will look bad, no. It's just that the player won't be able to notice the difference between the 3D models and 2D sprites. If you do a good job with the colors, you'll probably get away with it. Another problem with this approach is colliders. Although I showed you a way around it, it's still not a perfect solution. Choosing the right shape, scaling and positioning the collider can be hard. Sometimes you can even get complex shapes to recreate an object. For the same reason, making a building system might be difficult too, but not impossible. By the way, I'm thinking about exploring this approach more for my future games, and I was wondering if you'd be interested in some tutorials on it. We've looked at three ways to make an isometric game, talked about the pros and cons of each one of them, but the question still stands. What is the best approach for your game? In general, isometric view is very convenient for games where you want to know exactly where everything is positioned. These are construction type games, like simulations, tycoons and real-time strategies. I chose three criteria for this comparison: graphics, programming and gameplay. First, the 2D approach. In terms of graphics, you could use this approach if you want to do the art by yourself. Also, if you found some good isometric art for your game, but you just want to modify it a little bit, this one is the way to go for you. Also, if your game has a lot more buildings, but not that many characters, this approach is good for you too. This is because you can create a variety of houses, and animating a few characters will not take too much time. In terms of programming, you'd have to deal with a 2D project and tile maps. If you're familiar with it or willing to learn, this one is the way to go. As for the gameplay, a 2D isometric can be suitable for different games like City Builders, RTS, etc. But in my personal opinion, they're great for making simple, perhaps turn-based games. Next up is the 3D approach. 3D graphics can be tricky to make. A good use of this approach is if you have relatively simple buildings with not that many details. Another reason to use 3D is if you have a lot of moving characters with AI. The programming will involve things like dealing with a 3D project, of course, so you have to know how to work with lights, movement and other things. Also, you'd have to get really good with raycasting, because this is your everything for handling the player's mouse input. The gameplay for this type is probably Tycoon. This genre usually requires a lot of people to simulate the city, or a cafe, or any type of business. And the last but not least, the combined approach. The graphics combine two things, the detailed sprites and animated models. If you want to create a beautiful environment, but you also have a lot of characters to animate, this way is for you. The programming in this approach can bring you hard times with the colliders, as I've already said before, but overall it requires the same things as a regular 3D project, so no need to repeat that. As for the things you can do with this approach, these are city builders where both buildings and character are present, tycoons if you want a detailed environment and the characters, and even RTS. Of course, the list of things that you can make with isometric view does not end with this. These are just some examples that you can make. And this is it for this video. Thank you for watching. Comment down below about your favorite isometric games. What genres are they? And what approach do you think they use? Like this video and subscribe to my channel to see more game dev content. Bye!